Welcome to Meddy Simplified. Today we are going to talk about nasal polyps. What are nasal polyps? Nasal polyps are nothing but non-neoplastic edematous masses arising from either nose or sinuses, arising from nasal or both nasal and sinus mucosa. So they are non-neoplastic edematous mass arising from the nasal and sinus mucosa. In other words, we can call it as a pedunculated hypertrophied edematous mucosa. So there are some characteristics of this nasal polyps that are, they are painless, they appear pale in color, they are fleshy, and they do not bleed. So in case of nasal polyps, we will not see any epistaxis. No epistaxis, that is nasal bleed. Depending upon the site from where they origin, we have two types of nasal polyps. One is ethmoidal nasal polyps, another one is antrochoanal nasal polyps. We have two types of nasal polyp. One is ethmoidal nasal polyp, and another one is antrochoanal. This antrochoanal nasal polyp arises from mastoid antrum, whereas this ethmoidal nasal polyp arises from ethmoidal air cells. So first we'll talk about the ethmoidal nasal polyp, then we'll talk in detail about the antrochoanal nasal polyp. So what are ethmoidal polyp? Ethmoidal polyps are nothing but a multiple bilateral fleshy pearly white grape-like masses, arising from ethmoidal sinus or ethmoidal air cells. They can also originate from middle turbinate or middle nasal meatus. So ethmoidal nasal polyp are multiple bilateral fleshy pearly white grape like masses arising from the ethmoidal sinus. So they are common in male in comparison with female. They are seen in the age group of 30 to 60 years of age. And in case the ethmoidal nasal polyp, in case of ethmoidal nasal polyp, the recurrence are common. So now let's talk about the etiology. The etiology of this nasal polyps. The most common cause of nasal polyp is any allergy. So allergy is the most common etiology. Other causes are asthma, aspirin intolerance, Carter-Gennar syndrome, Churg-Strauss syndrome, and Young syndrome. There is a condition called as Samter's triad, which is a triad of three conditions, that is asthma, aspirin intolerance, and nasal polyps. So these three conditions combine to form Samter's triad. So till now we have discussed what are nasal polyps, the types, And first we are discussing about the ethmoidal nasal polyp. They are multiple bilaterally present pearly white grape-like masses arising from ethmoidal sinus. They have association with the diseases like asthma, Cartagena syndrome, aspirin intolerance, etc. Now we'll talk about the symptoms of this disease, symptoms of the nasal polyp. We have already discussed that they are present bilaterally, so they will cause bilateral nasal obstruction. Bilateral nasal obstruction. As there is a nasal obstruction, all the air which we are inspiring will not reach to the olfactory region of the nose, so there will be a loss of smell. So it can be a partial or complete loss of smell. Partial or complete anosmia. There will be a discharge from nasal cavity, which will give an appearance called as frog face deformity. Other symptoms which are seen is pain on the nasal bridge, then the patient will be presenting with a hyponasal voice. Now let's talk about the investigation part of this ethmoidal polyp. So what are the investigations we do in order to detect the ethmoidal polyp? First, we will do anterior rhinoscopy. In anterior rhinoscopy, what we will find? We will find a multiple bilateral pearly white mass, grape-like masses, which will be arising from either nasal or sinus mucosa. Then we will do x-ray in order to detect the extent of the disease. Then the third, that is non-contrast CT of nose and paranasal sinuses of nose and PNS. This is the investigation of choice. This is the investigation of choice in case of any polyp, either ethmoidal polyp or antrochoanal polyp. Now, this is how we will detect the ethmoidal polyp. Now, let's talk about the treatment. First, we'll talk about the conservative treatment. In the conservative treatment, we'll give antihistamines, or we'll give nasal corticosteroids. Both of this will just give symptomatic relief. As the case of reoccurrence is high in case of ethmoidal polyp, we usually go for surgery. So what are the surgical options in case of ethmoidal polyp? First, we'll do simple polypectomy. If it is usually done when we have one or maximum two nasal polyp, so we go for simple polypectomy. Second option which we have is ethmoidectomy. We'll remove the ethmoid sinus. Ethmoidectomy. Here we have three kind of ethmoidectomy. First is intranasal, second extranasal, third is transantral. So intranasal is usually done when we are going for any ethmoidectomy. The first preference is the intranasal ethmoidectomy in order to remove the multiple, more than one or two polyps. So if there is a recurrence occurring after intranasal ethmoidectomy, there is a recurrence, so we go for extranasal. In case of a recurrence, we go for extranasal ethmoidectomy. And the case when we use transantral ethmoidectomy is when this ethmoid polyp is affecting the mastoid antrum and there is involvement of mastoid antrum, that time we do transantral ethmoidectomy. Now the third and the last is FESS, that is functional endoscopic sinus surgery. It is the treatment of choice. It is the treatment of choice in case of ethmoidal polyps. Now, the second type of polyp, which we have already said about, that is antrochoanal polyp. Antrochoanal polyp. Talking about the name of this polyp, that is antrochoanal. So the antro means mastoid antrum. Mastoid antrum. And coanal is the posterior nasal passage in the nasal cavity. Posterior part of the nasal cavity. It is termed as coanal. Posterior nasal cavity. So the name is antrochoanal polyp. From the name now we are understood that it is arising from mastoid antrum, we call it as a antrochoanal polyp. It is also called as Killian's polyp. Also called as Killian's polyp. Antrochoanal polyp or Killian's polyp is a trilobed polyp. It is a trilobed polyp. And the three lobes are first present in the antrum part, that is antral lobe. Second is nasal lobe. And third is coanal lobe. Usually the antrochoanal polyp is a solitary. What is antrochoanal polyp? It is a solitary unilateral mass arising from the mastoid antrum, and we call it as an antrochoanal polyp. In case we have discussed, they are trilobed, so usually they create unilateral obstruction, but sometimes what happens, this coanal part of this antrochoanal polyp, the coanal lobe of this antrochoanal polyp will go back posteriorly, will grow posteriorly, and it will block the nasopharynx. So in this case we'll see bilateral obstruction. Usually we'll see unilateral obstruction, but due to overgrowth of this coanal part we'll see bilateral obstruction. So this was introduction of the antrochoanal polyp. One more thing, this antrochoanal polyp is usually seen in, is more common in male in comparison with females, and it is usually seen in young children. So now after this we'll discuss about the symptoms of the antrochoanal polyp, investigation, and at last the treatment. Till now we have discussed about the types and of nasal polyp, ethmoidal and antrochoanal, and we have discussed the ethmoidal part in detail, and now the remaining part of the antrochoanal will discuss. So what is antrochoanal polyp? It is a solitary sinonasal polyp that arises from the maxillary antrum or maxillary sinus. We have discussed the lobe, we have discussed the its epidemiology. Now we'll talk about the symptoms. Symptoms, I've already told that it is unilateral obstruction is seen, but if the coanal part, coanal lobe, grows posteriorly and blocks nasopharynx, we'll see bilateral obstruction. This was first. Second, we'll see nasal discharge, as we have seen in case of ethmoidal polyp. Nasal discharge. Third, we'll see hyponasal voice. The patient will present with the hyponasal voice. And the fourth is conductive type of hearing loss, which is usually due to blockage of eustachian tube. Blockage of eustachian tube. So this was the symptoms. Talking about the investigations, here as we have done in case of ethmoidal polyp, we do anterior rhinoscopy, but here in case when we do anterior rhinoscopy, sometimes we may not be able to see the polyp, so we do posterior rhinoscopy. We do posterior rhinoscopy, and in posterior rhinoscopy, what we will see? We'll see a spherical mass. We'll see a fleshy white spherical mass. Investigation of choice in both, I've already said, in both the types of polyp is NCCT of nose and PNS. So now let's talk about the treatment. Talking about the treatment, the conservative therapy, the drugs are having no role in case of antrochoanal polyp. So the treatment of choice is surgical, or the treatment which is opted is surgical. So what kind of surgery we do in case of antrochoanal polyp? First, we do intranasal polypectomy. We usually do intranasal polypectomy in case of children who have completed their dentition. In case of antrochoanal polyp, the recurrence is very low. It is almost near to zero. But if recurrence occur, so we go for Caldwell-Leuch's operation or Caldwell-Leuch's surgery. It is contraindicated in children less than 17 years. So Caldwell-Leuch surgery is done when the intranasal polypectomy is done and we see a recurrence of antrochoanal polyp. So in case of children whose age is more than 17 years, we go for Caldwell-Leuch surgery. And here also, in case of antrochoanal surgery, functional endoscopic sinus surgery is the treatment of choice, or it is used nowadays, or it is more preferable. So that was about both the types of antrochoanal, both the types of nasal polyps. So in short, once again, nasal polyp is a hypertrophied pedunculated edematous mass arising from the nasal or mucosal, nasal or sinus mucosa. They are of two types depending upon the site of origin, ethmoidal and the antrochoanal. Both are painless, both are insensitive to probing, both do not show epistaxis, and the investigation of choice for both the type is NCCT, that is non-contrast CT of the nose and paranasal sinus. Thank you. That was all about the nasal polyp. Thanks for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe the channel Meddy Simplified, and please do not forget to follow us on Instagram.